Hello everyone and welcome to Learn French with Lara.com. I'm Lara and today I'm going to give you a magic trick to be able to prepare well for your French GCSE speaking exam. So today we're looking at travel and tourism in French, GCSE speaking, talking about holidays in French. These are 8 possible French GCSE questions on that topic. Now, how do I answer this using the least effort? Well, you use a magic paragraph. So here is my magic paragraph. Je passe mes vacances au bord de mer. I spend my holidays by the seaside. Avec ma famille. With my family. Parce que c'est relaxant. Because it is relaxing. Et que les plages sont belles. And beaches are beautiful. Il fait beau. It is beautiful. The weather is beautiful. Alors, nous allons bronzer. Then, we're going to... Bronzer is to tan, have a suntan. Sur la plage, on the beach. D'une part, j'aime me relaxer en vacances. On one hand, I like to relax on the beach. Et d'autre part, on the other hand, j'aime faire les sports nautiques. I like to do water sports. C'est vraiment chouette. It's really super. C'est important de se relaxer en vacances pour recharger ses batteries. Où passes-tu normalement tes vacances? Well, this is perfect. We are using already the verb passé, okay, in the present tense. And all we can do is to add that normalement, okay, to our sentence. So here we are, normalement. I've just added the normalement with a comma. And here we go. So let's have a look. Normalement, je passe mes vacances au bord de mer avec ma famille parce que c'est relaxant et que les plages sont belles. Il fait beau, alors nous allons bronzer sur la plage. D'une part, j'aime me relaxer en vacances et d'autre part, j'aime faire les sports nautiques. C'est vraiment chouette. C'est important de se relaxer en vacances pour recharger ses batteries. Perfect. So this paragraph fits perfectly for that question. Now, let's have a look at the next one. Quel type de vacances préfères-tu et pourquoi? So we have préféré here that we need to reuse. Et pourquoi? So we need a reason. But in my paragraph, I have already given 2 reasons. Parce que c'est relaxant et que les plages sont belles. So dit parce que answers the question pourquoi. Now I just need to replace préfère. Donc je préfère passer. You need the infinitive. Add a. Je préfère passer mes vacances au bord de mer avec ma famille. Can keep the same paragraph. Okay, so here we have the pourquoi. But as explained before, maintenant qu'est-ce que tu aimes faire pendant les vacances? So you need to reuse aimer faire. You simply copy the aim. Put the apostrophe. J'aime. Now, j'aime is like je préfère. It's the same. You need to have the infinitive afterwards. So passé, you need to add the R. J'aime passer mes vacances au bord de mer avec ma famille parce que c'est relaxant et que les plages sont belles, etc., etc. So basically, you can reuse the same thing. Okay. Est-ce que tu penses que c'est important d'avoir des vacances? Donc, do you think it's important to have holidays? Alors là, you need to reuse penser que c'est important. So again, this is going to be without the S, with the first person. Que c'est important, and you can see that after important, you have the de, plus avoir des vacances. So you can basically simply reuse that. This is your question. Je pense que c'est important d'avoir des vacances. Okay. Maintenant, why is it important to have holiday? Well, let's get rid of all that. Just have a parce que. And what could be the reason? Well, we could just take the last bit here. Parce que, hop, je pense que c'est important d'avoir des vacances, parce que c'est important de se relaxer en vacances pour recharger ses batteries. Ok, décris tes dernières vacances. Où et quand es-tu allé en vacances? Avec qui? Qu'est-ce que tu as fait? Quel temps faisait-il? Ok, so here, you need to talk about your last holiday, so you need to use the past tense. What you can say? You simply add the auxiliary have, j'ai. Passé. So, passé with ER verbs, the E becomes E. J'ai passé. Now we're talking about dernière vacances. So here, I need to mention that these were the last one. J'ai passé mes dernières vacances au bord de mer. Où et quand es-tu allé en vacances? Donc, so, where and when? Well, you've already said mes dernières vacances, so they were the last one, so that answers the when. Et où, you've already said au bord de mer, okay, so that's answered. Avec qui? Well, you have said avec ma famille, so you have answered that one. Qu'est-ce que tu as fait? Problem is the tenses. Il fait beau. That is in the present tense. Now we need to talk about the past tense. So il fait becomes il faisait beau because we need in that case the perfect tense. Alors, nous allons becomes the past tense as well and you simply need to add the I. Allons. J'ai passé mes dernières vacances au bord de mer avec ma famille parce que c'est relaxant et que les plages sont belles. You don't need that parce que, because we don't really need a justification. Here's the question is to describe your last holiday. So I'll remove that. We talk about our last holiday. So in French, we're going to use the passé composé. So instead of allons, we're going to put nous sommes allés. Okay? Nous sommes allés is basically the passé composé of the verb aller. But the verb aller, which means to go, is a movement verb. So you need to use here the verb to be, être, in the present tense, and not the verb have, avoir, in the present tense, like here, j'ai passé, c'est vraiment chouette. Here we need to change the tense. So we need c'était. Again, we need the AIT for the perfect tense, it was, in French. C'était vraiment chouette. C'est important de se relaxer en vacances pour recharger ses batteries. Now, you don't need to change the tense here because this is a fact. You're saying it is important. Just a little bit. OK? Donc, décris une de tes sorties pendant tes vacances. You can start by saying that you were by the seaside. J'ai passé mes dernières vacances au bord de la mer avec ma famille. Il faisait beau, alors nous sommes allés bronzer sur la plage. To go and suntan on the beach could be an outing. So you can leave that. And if you want to say anything else, you can just add something in the infinitive. For example, if you wanted to say that you visited, you can say visiter le centre-ville. Now, d'une part, d'autre part, you can leave it or you can remove it. C'était vraiment chouette. C'est important de se relaxer en vacances pour recharger ses batteries. You can leave it. Okay, so the next question is, où vas-tu aller en vacances l'année prochaine? So here we are using vas-tu aller, we're using the futur proche, and we're talking about l'année prochaine. Basically, you reuse what's in the question. So l'année prochaine, next year, où vas-tu aller? You need to have the same tense. Verb to go is with je, is basically je vais aller. So you need to add a little I there. Je vais aller en vacances, you can just skip passer mes vacances because this is really the same except that with the futur proche you need the infinitive after the V. It's like when you say in English I'm going to. Donc passer, we need the R. L'année prochaine, je vais passer mes vacances au bord de mer avec ma famille parce que c'est relaxant et que les plages sont belles. That you can keep as it is. Il fait beau. Now, il fait is the present and now we need the future. Il fait becomes il fera. Il fera beau, alors nous allons bronzer. Donc, allons is a verb to go in the present tense. Well, here you need to know that it's the future tense. You just need the ER in front. Nous irons. This is the future. Nous irons bronzer sur la plage. D'une part, j'aime me relaxer en vacances et d'autre part, j'aime faire les sports nautiques. That you can keep. C'est vraiment chouette. Well, again, we have the present tense and we need to move it to the future tense. Okay? C'est vraiment chouette. Become ce sera. Sera is basically the verb to be in the future. Ce sera vraiment chouette. C'est important because that's your opinion. It doesn't change. It can stay like this. C'est important de se relaxer en vacances pour recharger ses batteries. Si tu gagnais au loto, où passerais-tu tes vacances? If you won the lottery, where would you spend your holidays? Again, I can use my magic paragraph. Now, you can see that si tu gagnais au loto, if you won the lottery, où passerais-tu tes vacances? Passerais, A-I-S, this is the sign that this is the conditional tense. So you need, basically, the conditional. Conditional is the infinitive plus the A ending. Start again with the question. And you say, si je gagnais au loto, because you're talking about yourself, if I won the lottery, so you need the conditional. And with je et tu, it's exactly the same. Donc, je passerai mes vacances au bord de mer avec ma famille, parce que c'est relaxant et que les plages sont belles. Il fait beau. We need to put fait in the conditional. There is the stem for the conditional and it is ER. Il ferait beau. Alors, nous, these stem things, I've actually explained it in my conjugation table, which I shared with you on my website. And the idea is to give you one eye blink all the different stems for all the tenses so you can easily find how to conjugate the verbs in French. Allons is the present tense, so we need to put it in the conditional and it is in fact very similar to the future tense. So if I take the future tense, we said iront, and to put the conditional, I simply need to add an I there. Alors, nous irions bronzer sur la plage. D'une part, j'aime me relaxer en vacances et d'autre part, j'aime faire les sports nautiques. That can stay the same. C'est vraiment chouette. Well, again, that c'est is the present. It needs to be the conditional. Ce serait vraiment chouette. C'est important de se relaxer en vacances pour recharger ses batteries. Okay, so here we are. We have answered 8 questions. Alright, so this is the end of our video. If you like this, please like and subscribe. You can have a look at my French GCSE demo course on my website. And I also have a full course available with all the different lessons. And this is really to help you achieve top marks at your French GCSE exam. Happy French learning. See you later. Bye-bye.